Cherokees are close to the language because that is at the center of who we believe we are.
Jo, dag til. Altså lagt gode næste gæsse. Skrids gås og dag til gæsse. Og til lagt næste, det kan låse.
We're losing fluent speakers daily. We know that. We cannot replace them fast enough with one immersion school. We'll never be able to keep pace with the elders who are passing, bringing up children in the immersion school. We've got to get the Cherokee language infused into the area. That's the goal here, is to get it not just at the immersion school of the Cherokee Nation, but some Cherokee language into the public school systems, into everyday life here.
There are a lot of reasons given for why the older generation stopped teaching the language to their kids. Television was one. Mixed marriages where the common language of the home was English. Growing cities and easier transportation meant that more business was conducted in English. The biggest reason, it seems, was enrollment in public schools. In some cases, kids who spoke Cherokee as their first language learned English by immersion. In 2002, the Cherokee Nation started a language immersion school in response to a survey about the importance of the language to the tribal members.
Let's use the very same things that were done to us to eradicate our language and culture. Immersion. Let's put let's take that system that took it away from us and make it a system to put it back.
Elena Harkreader has gone to the school since it opened when she was 3 years old. She recently graduated from sixth grade with 8 other students. For her family, this was a huge accomplishment. Elena's grandmother speaks Cherokee, but she never passed it on to Elena's mother.
There will be times when her and her brother will be both in trouble when they're teenagers, and they'll be talking about me, and I won't know it because it'll be in Cherokee. That's what I hope for, is that we will have a family full of Cherokee speakers, and it's not going to be a big deal because it's going to be their way of life.
This is the first graduation for Cherokee-speaking students from a Cherokee school.
That's what I hope for, is that we do save the language in our family, if not in anything else, but in our family. I want to be able to say that we gave it our all and that it paid off.
Yeah, we may be divided on one thing or another, but what unifies us is the language and the culture, and those are two things that we cannot see that can be ever split. The culture and the language are one and the same. That's how we talk about our culture. Saying things about the culture in English just doesn't have the same ring that it does in Cherokee.
My hopes is that she will pick up where I leave off. In some way, she will be passing the language to someone else.